So, yeah, like what's your answer to this?
Okay, why would I give up a pizza? I mean, it's so funny, right? I have to give up a pizza for rape. I would like give up my whole everything for people to stop raping. And I think partially why is because I feel that's not right. Like, it does not cause enough justice to the person who is harmed to it.
Okay.
The person doing it does not really think, or I don't know, probably dick in his brains. So that's my problem, but I feel bad for, I think, the victim, and that's what affects me a lot.
So why is rape immoral?
Firstly,
is rape immoral?
It is, because you're doing something without consent.
Okay.
So I think that's why it's immoral.
Is that the only reason why it's immoral?
I
can give you an example what I mean, right? So I have a phone over here. If someone were to steal my phone, which means they took something from me without my consent,
yeah,
without my permission.
Yeah.
That is how stealing is bad. But stealing and raping, there's a lack of consent in both of those, but are not even on the same level, right?
Yeah.
So what makes rape even more horrible as compared to stealing?
Personally, I haven't had the worst situation with something like this, but I've encountered something.
Mm-hmm.
I went out to drink with my friends, and there was this guy, and he was really nice, and he was talking to me very sweetly, and he was an old man, mind you, and by the end of it, he decided to kiss me, which I just pushed my face away, and I felt so weird, and I feel so weird every other day when I'm drinking. So imagine, just like, that tiny kiss made me like question, why did that even happen to me, right? That something so much more than just a kiss is, I think, wrong. Like, don't do that to someone if they're not giving you that consent.
So, I hear you. When you speak about, we already discussed about consent.
Yeah.
Right? So, what are other things?
Consent
is one thing.
Yeah.
What are the other things which, let's say, what does the victim go through?
Yeah, every day after that, sleepless nights.
Yeah.
Like a lot of drama, like, dude, it's so messed up, right? You can't even do, sometimes girls choose not to do shit about it,
mm-hmm.
which is so messed up. So basically, it's like the whoever did it just gets to go away with it,
mm-hmm.
but the person who dealt with it has to face it every day until they heal from it, which is so messed up. So fuck consent. I think it's about how you're going to deal with it every day after that. That's the fucked up part.
You mean it causes mental trauma?
Yeah, a lot of it.
Okay. And might I even add that raping someone means we are taking away their bodily autonomy?
Yeah.
We are taking away their agency?
Yeah.
And it's also physically abusive?
Yeah.
Would you wish that pain upon anyone?
Never.
In any circumstance?
Never.
You sure about it?
Yes.
Alright. So when it comes to it, let me take a hypothetical situation.
Yeah.
Where a person is about to commit the crime of rape.
Yeah.
Okay. And in this hypothetical situation, you had the chance to talk to them, to reason with them. They're not going to tell you anything. They're only going to listen to reason and logic. And if you give very good reasoning, they're willing to change their mind about it.
Okay.
But what you can't do is call cops on them or anything.
Yeah.
Think of it as like it's just a conversation. After that, you have no way of locating them or anything. What would you tell them?
Imagine it was your mom.
And if he says fine with that?
That's fucked up. If you can wish for bad for your mom, you can wish
what
bad.
What if he's an orphan? Why do we even have to assume he could be?
Okay,
anybody.
She. Yeah, I
no,
would.
Not like I'm taking sides.
Yeah, no.
I'm saying
true.
Victimizer could be anyone.
Anybody, right? Yes, I agree with you. What would I say? I would have no words. I'd probably start crying, dude. For the emotional person I am, I'd first start crying and I would just ask the person, like, what made you feel it's okay to do it? That would be my first question. What makes you feel that, like, hey, listen, dude, this is right. I'm going to do this. I'm going to ask them so I can understand where they're coming from, right? That would be my first thing. And the second thing I think would be, imagine this was done to you. Like, imagine you had no option and that's your option. Like, that's what you're going to deal with. Would you be okay with it? So I probably will play like a few mind games with the person and ask them into why and what, so I can make them understand how it's not okay.
So what I was saying is, I mentioned before that the person, the victimizer, the about to be victimizer, is not going to tell you why.
Yeah.
They are only willing to listen to logic and reasoning. They are not interested in answering. What would you say?
I am going to take my friend's help.
That's fine. You can keep with your answer.
I'm not sure. I don't know what I would say because it's so fucked up, dude.
Alright, let me tweak it a little bit.
Thanks, yeah.
Okay. Instead of, let's say for some reason they were convinced with your reasoning.
Yeah.
I don't know how effective it might be or not, but let's consider that. Okay. Now they say, fine, I won't rape them because it causes mental trauma, right? There's a life full of suffering. I'll just end their life. I'll just murder them. Would you take it as an okay compromise or would you still try to talk them out of it?
Sorry, you're telling me the rapist has to get killed
or the person
deserves to be murdered?
No. They say that the victimizer, they say, you know what, I hear you, there would be suffering that might not be right, life full of suffering is not worth it. Instead of raping them, I'll just kill them.
Yeah.
Would you think that is an okay compromise from their side? Or would you still try to talk
That's
them
so
out?
That's so fucked up. We're not even giving you our body and now you choose to take away our life?
Right.
Fuck you. Okay. No, I'm not okay with that. Yeah.
Alright. So let's say they listen to this. Like, fine. I won't rape a human. I won't murder a human. I'll go rape an animal instead. Would you be okay with that or would you still try to talk them out?
I would still. Okay, so you're telling me a thing that can't talk, you're ready to go do that to a thing that can't talk? That's really fucked up, bro.
Okay. Thing?
An animal.
They're not things, right?
Yeah, sorry. No, how could you do it to something that doesn't talk?
Yeah, thing.
Okay, sorry, my friend. I take it back.
I mean, only thing is, don't look at them as things. Look at them as beings.
Yeah, it's my lingo. It's not that I said things.
Yeah, yeah. It's like I'm hoping about that. Yeah. But what would you tell them why raping an animal is wrong?
Say
mental trauma, physical abuse, all of those things.
More than that, an animal is so loyal. I don't think an animal deserves some. I have 3 dogs and dude, I can't even like shout at my dog because I feel so bad because Luca can't tell me anything. Like, what is he going to say? Sorry? So I feel bad to even shout at him. So I think rape is way too much.
So what do you call raping an animal is also cruel?
Very.
How do you define cruelty?
Probably things that are not okay, like morally not right.
Okay. So, what is moral then? That would be a bigger question, right? Cruelty would be easier thing to define, but if you want to define morality, that's also fine.
No, I'll define cruelty.
Yeah.
So, I think,
Damn. It's okay to take your time.
Yeah.
It's generally okay. But let's say if you aren't able to.
Yeah.
If I give you a few examples of cruelty, would you be able to say it's cruel or not?
Sure, okay.
Alright. So before I go there, I wanted to ask, since we're talking about cruelty towards animals, are you against animal cruelty?
Yes, I am.
Which types of animal cruelty are you against?
I'm not okay with shouting at your dog. Uh-huh. I'm not okay with you hitting your animal. Actually, I have a dog, Berry, and basically for like 5 months, I would see Berry just tied up, okay? And in my neighbor's house. So this is my house and this is Berry's house, okay? And every day, so my dog is a Newfoundland dog and he's a big dog, okay? And he has a lot of fur. So ideally, he's supposed to sit under like an AC or something. So yeah, so this dog would just sit right over there and these guys would not give a fuck, like they would just let him sit there and it would be it hot, be it cold, be it let it rain, let it anything happen, that dog is gonna still be there. And my mom and me can't take it, okay? So what we would do is we'd start screaming like, hey Berry, do you want us to save you, should we take you away, oh my god, why are they doing this to you, how could they do this to you? And I would insult the freaking owners so much, trying to tell them like, hey dude, don't tie up your dog, or just give your dog away if you can't take care of it, right? This fucker is just purposely doing it.
They have a history of doing it.
Yeah, anyways. So,
you said you would try to insult the owners.
Yeah, I would do all of it. I would try so hard to make them understand, hey buddy, what you're doing is not right, okay? And they did not get it. That 4 months later, I go to them, I'm like, hey listen, I don't think you can take care of your dog, can I please adopt your dog?
Yeah.
And It didn't matter about whether the dog was happy or not. They didn't care. They were just like, yeah, you pay me, I'll give you my dog. And I didn't give a shit. I was like, yeah, I'll pay you whatever you want. I'm still taking your dog because I can't see
it. Insulting didn't work.
Nothing worked.
Okay. Fine. So could you give me another example of animal cruelty which might not include dogs or cats?
Okay. I think when you see like animals around here and you know, you see them like really sick or probably injured or something and you don't do something about it, that's also cruelty because like, how are they going to help themselves? Get up and walk to the hospital? No, right? So I feel like you should like be able to take your animal to a vet or something. I mean, the animal to the vet.
All right. I mean, that's one way to look at it because we call them as stray animals.
Yeah.
But they are just as much part of the society as anyone else. Right?
Yeah.
So it would become our social responsibility.
Yes. Right?
But you can't force someone to go and help them. Totally up to them if they are willing to or not.
But I probably would. And I consider that okay to do. Like, this one night, my friends literally stayed out all night trying to get like this mother, like a lactating mom, like help. So it's not about whether you want to do it or not. I feel like being a part of a society, as you said, it's your right to do it.
Duty.
Yeah.
There's a difference between right and duty.
Okay.
You can choose not to exercise your right.
Yeah.
You have to still fulfill your duty.
Yeah.
Okay, so as I said, I'll give you a few examples of animal cruelty which I think are wrong. You let me know if you agree with it or not.
Okay.
What do you think about enslaving animals?
That's messed up too because so here's the story. I have so many stories. I wanna have a pet lion, okay? And I wanna get it as a cub and then keep it. But the only thing that stops me obviously is my country. I can't just pick one from somewhere. And the second thing I think is the fact that I'm gonna be keeping it. I have a farm full of animals and stuff, so we have
sanctuary.
A farm.
As in
it's just a
farm or something?
Yeah. So it's pretty big and if I wish I could like try to get this right, but I feel so bad because it's right home is the jungle. So I'm even though this place is going to be big and it's going to like get all my love and get everything, I just feel it's not right because that's where its home is.
Right.
And on that note, I have to go.
I didn't even get to make the point that I had to.
Sorry, yes, I was going to ask you your point before I go.
So, fine, I'll just jump to the point.
Yeah.
Did you figure out the connection between pizza and rape?
No.
Try to make a guess how they might be connected.
It's
not a hypothetical outcome.
I'm very bad at this.
Pizza contains cheese on it, right?
Yeah.
Where do you get that cheese?
From milk?
Yeah, but from where?
From an animal.
Which ones?
Cows.
And?
Goats.
And? Buffaloes.
Yeah.
And when do they produce it?
When they have to give it to their babies.
After birth?
Yeah.
Not before birth, right?
I'm not sure. I think cows start lactating before they get their baby. Like, and then it's like that period because I have cows too. But on this note, here's the thing. A lot of people abuse these animals, right? But sometimes it's good for you to take away like some of the... I'm not sure about whether my point stands right. But... So I have an Instagram account for my farm and someone said, oh my God, you're doing this to your cows, blah, blah, blah. But ideally, like, we realize that it's okay to sometimes take away milk from them, but not exceed the amount of milk you take away from them.
How much is it okay to take from them?
This I'm not sure about. That's why I didn't want to make my point.
Thing is, no mother produces more milk than the baby requires.
Okay.
And then unless you have genetically modified them and screwed up their hormones, that's the only place.
Yeah.
Which means we have reduced them already to milk-making machines. Right?
Hmm.
But again, what I would say is, what gives you the right? If you remember, this is the exact point you were making to the to be rapist.
Yeah.
I'm not calling you a rapist.
Yes.
Let me make that distinction. You said that what gives you the right to think it's okay to touch someone without consent, to steal from them without consent.
So this is your cause for animal?
Regardless of that, I mean, I'll tell you exactly what it is. Question is, what gives us the right to touch them without their consent? For only our desires. Not like we are doing for the benefit of them, right?
Yeah.
Are we doing
But like I said, I'm not sure. I am going to probably text you, find your Instagram and text you about whether this is okay or not.
Mm-hmm.
Because Yeah, like I said, I don't know the thing and I want to say that, but I don't know it, so I don't want to just jump into a conclusion.
Again, I would still make a point. Do we have any right to touch someone without consent?
No, we do.
To touch their breast without consent?
No, we do.
To take the baby food, which was only for that calf, for us?
No, not right.
Why do we even take it?
For ourselves, which is so... You're making me feel like a piece of shit. I really...
That's not me, that's your conscience.
Yeah, because I love animals. Yeah. And I'm feeling like a... Yeah, it's very wrong. I look deep.
So, why does this problem exist?
Because of us.
No, but why? There are so many problems
that
exist.
Because of our needs.
Needs, you say?
Yeah, because apparently we need milk. I'm not going to drink milk anymore, bro.
No, but do we need milk?
No, we don't.
So it's not a need, right?
Yeah.
So why does this problem exist? Not for our needs, right?
Yeah.
Wants?
Yeah.
Desires? Habits?
Yep.
Are those reasons good enough to do the things we do to the animals? Alright. Again, this problem exists because of our desires. Yeah. What do you think is the solution from your side? What's your name?
Shania.
Sorry?
Shania.
Shania. Nice name.
Thank you.
So, Shania, what can you do as an individual to stop this problem?
Let's see. Bring more awareness to why we should... I don't know. I don't know what I can do. Even if I try to do something, I don't know if my... Like I said, right, my opinion won't matter.
It's not about opinions, it's about actions, right?
Yeah, but there's not... I don't think one person can change 100 people. So maybe I'll like...
Talk to the person who spread coronavirus.
Yeah, I wish I could do this. No, but
despite that, you talking to others, before that, do you think you have the power to control your own self?
Yeah, I'm going to stop drinking milk. I'm turning vegan because of you. Thanks.
You guarantee that?
I feel like shit. I'm going to go crypto my friends like, no, stop drinking milk.
But before you do that, what I'll do is I'll share you a resource card. I hope that you completely try to understand the reason why I say that, okay? There are some documentaries on YouTube. Please watch that. That would explain you why doing this to animals is wrong.
Okay. Yeah.
And make sure to think about that question.
Yes.
Because every single time that we choose to consume animal products...
No, stop. Right? Yes, I feel you, brother. Thank you.
Not just milk or milk products. Flesh, eggs, honey, or any sort of animal products or even services.
Yeah.
Someone is enslaved, tortured, and even, their rights are violated.
Yeah.
Because of our choices. While all we had to do is choose something else. Right? So please make sure you go through it. Okay?
What's your name?
I'm Agastya.
Okay. Amazing talking to you.
Thank you.
Thank you.